Well, hello everybody and welcome back to another Minecraft video. This is Mythical Sausage. How is everybody doing? Oh man, I'm doing great. Hopefully you guys are doing amazing because we are back again here doing another tutorial. And today I'm going to show you guys how to build this awesome cow farm. And it's pretty cool. Inside is like a little automatic cow crusher, which is really awesome if you want some early game food in your world. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how to build this thing right now, block for block. Let's go. Now here's the materials you're going to be needing for the cow farm. Super simple. All you're going to be needing is some oak logs, some stripped oak, some spruce, and a couple little things along the way. And here's the dimensions of the build. Everything's all laid out in wool. Count out the blocks, find yourself a nice spot, and we're going to get this started. Wherever you see any of the logs, we're going to pop up logs from there, and then the surrounding border just is the foundation for the structure. The cow crusher is going to go right here in the center, but you don't need to put this. If you just want to use the structure itself, you can pretty much put any animal inside, and I'll give you guys options if you want to set that up. But for right now, let's get it started with the outline. Now let's get it started right here in this corner. I'm going to bring up this log here only up by 1, 2, and 3. Right here, we're going to put one log and then one log down. I'm going to grab a spruce stair. Let's put those down on top of those exposed logs. Give it a space of 2. And here we're going to go up 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I'm going to put a log here on this side and a stair on top. Right next to the oak log, we're going to put a barrel down, then grab some stripped oak and let's go up 1, 2, and 3. Put a little cross beam right there. Give it a space of 3. We're going to do another barrel right here on this side. And then again, stripped oak, 1, 2, and 3. Take the oak right next to it. We're going to go up 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then cross beam connecting those together. Put an oak right down here and a stair on top. Right in front of this, we're going to put an upside down stair, another upside down stair here. Trap door in the center. And then grab the trap doors. And let's take these down all the way to the floor on both sides. So it should look like this. Now we're going to turn this corner again, space it 2, matching what we did on the other side. Let's take this up 1, 2, and 3. One log here, one here. Stair on top, stair on top. Now we're going to go in between here and let's put 2 barrels here. Put another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and turn this one to the side. So we should have this front section. Then let's mirror what we did on that side. Let's go with our log right here. 1, 2, and 3. One on each side. Stair on top, stair on top. Let's turn this corner, space it 2. Let's mirror that side first before we fill this wall up. So here again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We're going to put a log right here. Stair on top. Here we're going to go with our barrel, put that down. We're going to grab our stripped oak and go up 1, 2, and 3. Cross beam right here. Space of 3, mirror that side. So we're going to put a barrel, a log going up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stripped 1, 2, and 3. And then cross beam right here with oak connecting to the other side, like so. Drop our log, put our stair on top, and then mirror this side. So we're going to put our stair upside down on both sides, trap door on the top. And then bring your trapdoors up on both sides here and make sure you close those up. So this side is mirrored to the other. Over here, same thing. We're going to do our log 1, 2, 3. One on each side. Stair down, stair down. Got the space of 2. But then we're going to grab our barrels and do the same thing we did on the other side. So 1 and 2 right here. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then turn that corner and it should connect just like so. Now from here, before we fill out the walls, let's go ahead and put our roof in place. So right here, we're going to grab a stair of spruce, take that down, overhanging that bit. Then I'm going to grab a slab, go underneath, put one here, one out, one underneath, one out, one underneath, and then one out. And it should go perfectly there to that side. And then let's keep it going. So we're going to put a stair upside down here, stair facing forward, upside down right here, stair facing forward, upside down right here. And then we're going to grab our slabs, but let's put one on top. And then double that up, and that should be the center bit. Now from here, we're going to go with an upside down stair, stair forward, upside down stair. Now we're going to go with slabs to the center. So one slab on top, double slab, and a double slab right here. Going to get rid of the bottom one, but then we're going to put a little placeholder block and then pop a log out. So this is going to go back to the other side. So we have this look to it. Then we're just going to repeat it over here on this end. So let's go with a stair here, pop that out, upside down. Stair forward, upside down, and then slab and double slab. So it should end like this. Now let's keep it going over here. So slab underneath, double slab here, and then one popping out. So that's how the roof should look like for now. Now let's go ahead and extend this slab all the way down to the end and then repeat it. So we're going to go with a double slab, single slab, stair on top. This should match perfectly going that direction right there. Then upside down stair, stair forward, upside down, then slab till we get to the center, which should go perfectly right here. We can get rid of that bit, and then we can just extend our log going all the way until it overhangs right there, one out from that section. Then let's repeat it over here. So stair down, going over, upside down stair, stair forward, upside down, and then slabs till we get to the center bit like so, and then bring this one down. So slab under, one over, underneath, over, underneath, and then one over, and this should go perfectly connecting to this section here. Then all we gotta do is just connect everything together from one side to the next, just like this, until we get to this section. These are gonna be stairs going all the way down, like so. Another set of stairs going all the way down right here. And then from this section, we're just gonna grab our slabs, take that all the way down, and take this one all the way down right here. Then just repeat this over here on this side. Now at the end, the roof should be connected just like this. We're gonna add a tower in a second, but before we do, let's go on the inside and fill this section in. So for this section, I'm gonna go with a mix of our stripped oak and our stripped spruce. So oak first on this one. So 1, 2, and 3. We're gonna put our spruce here, 1 and 2. That's gonna give you a little gap, but we'll fix that in a second. Here we're gonna do our stripped every other one, just like so. And then our oak going up like this, and then this one connects right there. We're going to just fill in this little gap just by covering it up on the inside like so. Then we're just going to repeat it over here on this side. So we're going to go up 1, 2, and 3. Here we're going to go with the spruce, 1 and 2, 1 and 2 on every other one, just like so. And then the oak on the gaps we missed, just like that. This one goes all the way to the top. Fill in this little section on the inside, and this part is mirrored now to that side. Now we're going to do the same style up here. So we're going to grab the oak, we're going to put one in this section, one in the middle, and then one in this section, and then spruce into those gaps. We're going to do the same thing over here. So oak, oak, and oak, and then strip spruce on the two sides. Then we're just going to play around with these details just so we can cover this up. So for this one, we're going to go ahead and just give it that lip right here on the top. Take it all the way down. Take this one also all the way down like so. Then here, we're going to go with our slabs. Slabs on this side like this. And then we're going to put trap doors in this section. And it gives you a nice curve on the inside. And you can leave it like this. You don't need to put the tower on top. I'm going to add that though for the extra bits of detail. Now you can have this side open and this side open. So you get almost like a barn look. You can go in and out from both sides. Or you can seal these up if you like. If you wanted to seal one up, probably the best way to do it is just grab trap doors and take these all the way up like this. And then just close them up. And you have yourself like a sealed barn door on one side. So maybe you can have one open, one closed, both open, or both closed. It's all up to you guys. If you wanted to have a door though, you could just get rid of these two and just add a door on this side. So it should look like this. Now one small bit of detail right here on the bottom part, I want to give this a little bit more. So I'm going to take these down so you have these two slabs underneath the roof, and you can also do it over here on this side. So it should look like that. Also, I want to give this a little bit of an overhang bit. Before we do that though, I want to put a couple trapdoors there just to give you a nicer curve. And then here, I'm going to go with an upside down stair, trapdoors on the top bit. And here, I'm going to go with some campfire blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then extinguish these. Then extra sets of trapdoors on the top layer, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. That gives you a nice little overhang bit there. And then we just repeat this on the other side. So one more time over here, upside down, trapdoors going down this row, 1 and 1 on each side here, campfire blocks on the top bit, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then we got our trapdoors on top, and then extinguish these up here. And then the same thing we did on the other side, let's match them right there. And then another set of slabs going down right here. So then this side is mirrored to the other. Tiny bit of detail, I'm going to put a button right there on the exposed log. Now this is done if you want it to be, but if you wanted to add a tower to give you a little bit more details and interest in the center, let me show you how to do that right here. Now first thing you need to do is find the center point, so that should be it. If you count, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 slabs on the top here, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 slabs on the top here. Yeah, that button before I forget. Then next up, we're going to knock down this section over here, just like so. We're gonna go up from here, 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3. You can also get rid of the center bit, like so. Get rid of those. You can have a little spot down there that you can see up. Now, another thing you can do is put a log sideways here. Turn that one, and we're gonna turn this one right here. Now, I wanna grab some of the strip spruce, and let's turn that sideways on the top here. Turn that one on the top. Turn that one here, and then let's turn that one over here. I'm gonna put a fence in the middle of all of those, like so. Then I'm gonna take these up one more on each cross beam on the top bits, but we're gonna cross beam here with the stripped spruce, like so. Then over here, we're gonna put upside down stairs on every single one of the oak logs, like this. Slabs in the gaps we missed, like so. I'm gonna go with a stair in the center, going around like this. Then trap doors in the little side upside down stairs, like so. I'm gonna grab our spruce and let's go ahead and give it a little bit of a row around, like so. I'm gonna put a full block on top in the center. I'm gonna put some stairs facing this direction. That's the front, that's the back. And then stairs facing this direction, like so. Stairs on top of those four blocks we placed. Full block on top, like this. Then I'm gonna grab a wall. I'm gonna go with a stone brick wall. You can go with any wall though. And then above, I'm gonna go with two fences, just like that. For extra detail bits, I'm gonna grab our trap doors. I'm gonna put one on the top above that stair, and then one more over here. We're gonna do that all the way around, and this gives us a nice little trim going all around the tower, just like this. Then for added details, I'm gonna put some shutters over here. So I'm gonna put a little shutter on this side with oak, one on this side, one over here, and then one more on this side. Now, one more bit of detail that I wanna do, I actually wanna get rid of this bit right here. I wanna put a little flower box in the center, put a trap door on top, get rid of these two bits, and let's put stairs. So let's put a stair this way, a stair this way, and I'm gonna add a little berry bush on the top. I'm gonna do the same thing over here on this end. So let's get rid of the middle, add a little flower pot right there. We're gonna go ahead and put our both stairs, trap door in the center. I'm gonna put a berry bush. You could put any plant though you want. And we got that little bit of detail just to add on the top. Now let's jump on the inside and work on the cow crusher. It should be centered perfectly to the top right there. So there is where we're gonna be putting our hopper. Before we do that though, let's put a chest right here on the side. Put a hopper, face it that direction. Make sure it is facing and pointing inside the chest. Then over here, we're gonna be placing another oak and one oak here. I'm gonna place a placeholder right there. I'm gonna put an upside down stair right here in the corner so we can access the chest. Over here, I'm gonna put two stairs. Over here, I'm gonna put two more stairs. And then we're gonna take this up one more right on each side and then one in the middle, just like this. I'm gonna go right in the center and I'm gonna drop some water and it's gonna go right there at the bottom. Then all we gotta do is lure some cows over here, either with a lead or with some wheat. Just make sure they fall in there. For right now, I'm just gonna put two in there. There you go, the easy way. Then I'm gonna place some trap doors around it, just like that. We're pretty much done, but one small thing we gotta do is a fence in the middle so none of the cows jump out of here. Now, all we gotta do is just breed them a bunch. Once we get a bunch in there, eventually they'll do some entity cramming and they'll die, like that. And all the drops are gonna go right in the inside. Just keep feeding them. The more you feed them, I believe it says over a certain amount, they will all get entity crammed and fall down here. Now let's jump over here on this wall. We're gonna put a crafting bench on this side. I'm gonna put a barrel on each side here. Let's put a row of furnaces, but let's add a bunch of smokers so we can use these to cook all the meat. On the side, we can add even more barrels, just going up right to the top, just like that, and then match it going over here on this end, like this. Eventually, you're just gonna mirror it over here on this side. Now for added details, I'm gonna put a composter on this side, composter on that side, grab some bushes, let's go up by two, gonna mirror it over here, so one on each side, bring up your bushes, and bring up your bushes over here on this end. Now we need to work on some lighting, so the idea I have right here is let's actually get rid of this spot right over here, let's get rid of that bit, let's get rid of this one and this one. We can also get rid of the slabs in front of it, slabs in front. And let's grab a beam of our oak and take it all the way down from one side to the next. Let's do another one going this way. And then we can just add some lanterns hanging from the center, just like that. For even more details, we can put some upside down stairs on each side right here, just so you don't see that little exposed log right there with that spruce. So we got this look to it. We got a nice curve, some nice hanging lights, and then we have a little way up to look. If you want, you can cover all this up if you don't want any of this kind of in the way. If anything, we can add a trap door of our oak right in the center. That might break it up a little bit, and it still looks pretty good. Now, little small details you could do is maybe add a little bit of coarse dirt down here just to make it look a little bit more animal pen-like. You can also add some pods on here, maybe even some gravel, maybe even some path block. Just make it look pretty good. Again, you can always close this up. You can pretty much mirror what we did on that side. I'm gonna leave it open, but for right now, I think this is pretty much all we need. The build is complete. And there it is, adding a little bit of detail on the outside just to dress up the build itself. Some hay bales, some bushes, some little rocks on the ground, some path, some fencing, some bushes, a little bit of bone meal. And it looks really, really awesome now in this area. So once you finish with your structures, make sure you dress around the area so the build stands out just a little bit more. Oh, and I added one lantern on the top. We needed some lights on the outside. But that is it. That is all there is to it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Let me know if you guys want any other tutorials of any other structures, any other barns, builds, maybe small early game farms that you can add, maybe chicken coops, stuff like that. Let me know. Chicken cooker too. How about that? But I'm out of here for now. Thank you so much for watching. Catch you guys on the next one. Goodbye.